Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. In this video, I am going to demonstrate you how you can find out length of a string using dynamic memory allocation. Before starting, you can note how you can search my YouTube channel. You can type my name Sanjay Gupta in YouTube search bar. My channel will be available there. You can open it here. Various programming related videos and playlists are available. You can also download my programming app, that is Techimiz, which is available on Google Play. Now I am going to implement solution of this problem. So for that purpose, first I am including a header file, that is stdio.h, another header file stdlib.h. Now I am defining main function. Inside main function, I am declaring a variable that is integer type n and variable c. C is initialized with 0. Now I am declaring a character pointer, that is p. With the help of printf, I am going to display the message enter size of string. To receive that size, I am using scanf. Entered size will be stored inside n variable. Now I have to allocate dynamic memory. So I am calling malloc function. So with this malloc function, memory blocks will be allocated that will be equals to n into size of character. So this memory block will be allocated. Malloc will return a base address of that memory location. It will be typecasted into character pointer, and then address will be stored inside p pointer. So this block is responsible for dynamic memory allocation. Now I can read the string from user. So this printf will print the message on console, or you can say output screen. Now I have to call a function fflush, where I am passing std in. So this function will clear the input buffer so that after reading integers, I can properly read characters from user. So now I am calling gets, and the entered string will be stored inside p pointer. So p is pointing to the entered string. Now I can implement a loop, and through that loop I can count how many characters are available in that allocated memory location with the help of p pointer. So for that purpose, I am implementing while loop. Inside while loop, I am going to implement a condition, that is asterisk p plus I not equals to null. So p is having base address of the memory location, and here I am going to initialize I with 0, and I am declaring I in integer variable declaration. So I is 0, so I will be added into p pointer, so that first location can be pointed through this pointer. And through this asterisk symbol, I can access the value that is available on that location. So if that value is not equals to null, then I can write C++. So C is a counter variable which will count how many characters are available in a string. Then I++. So I will be incremented by 1 every time. So P will be added with I, and new addresses will be created, and those values will be identified with the help of asterisk symbol. So it is representing here dereferencing scenario. So if p plus I is dereferenced and it is not equals to null, then only this loop will repeat, otherwise it will be terminated. So after completion of this loop, I can print the value of c on console, that is length equals to %d and then c. So this way I can print the value of c on output screen, and after printing I can call free function, which will deallocate the dynamically allocated memory. So this is the complete program which will count how many characters are available in a string, and this program is implemented with the help of malloc function that is responsible for dynamic memory allocation. So I am entering size as 6, and I am entering India as input. So you can see length equals to 5. So I have just entered 5 characters, so it is counting those characters properly. So with this way, I have implemented the solution of the problem in front of you with the help of dynamic memory allocation. I hope you have understood how I have implemented this. If you want to watch more programming related videos, you can search my YouTube channel by my name Sanjay Gupta in YouTube. My channel contains various programming related videos. Thank you for watching this video.